How's it going, everyone? I'm Jeff in Raleigh, your trusted Toyota resource. It's a great day to be standing in the back of a Toyota Tacoma bed. Yeah. It's also a great day to talk about the benefits, key highlights of 2020 RAV4 LE. The RAV4 LE is very important to Toyota's lineup because this is the base model, the entry level. When people have a budget, this is the place to go. When you don't need leather seats, this is the place to go. Let me show you the standard equipment on it and why I think this is such a cool option to consider. RAV4 has been redesigned, retooled, restyled with an all-new modern, spacious interior. It's got a tall, sturdy exterior frame, new platform to improve driving performance, styling, noise, all that kind of stuff. It's loaded with technology, loaded with safety features. It's got 8 airbags, comes standard on this LE with a 7-inch touchscreen that plays Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, Amazon Alexa, so you can be wired in. You have access to Google Maps, the iPhone Maps, and also Waze. So, I mean, you've got everything that you would get on a higher level trim, but you don't need all that sometimes. This is what the interior looks like. This is called macadamia. A lot of us know it as beige or bisque in other levels. It looks beige to me. But anyway, it's a nice pleasant color. It's not too yellow. It's not too brown. And it's offset by dark grayish black and chrome accents, which kind of break up the interior. And I think the lighter the interior you get, the more spacious it feels inside as well. Less confining. Here we've got a nice big back seat. Now, if you want rear USB ports, then you'll be looking at the XLE model. However, this one here, look at this. You can add 2 USB ports back right there. This was done at the regional port level. You can also do it at the dealership level. And then just here's a quick scan of the interior. A few bullet points and then a couple words of caution with this level as well. The benefit I see here, standard across the board LED headlamps and also daytime running lights. That's big. If you notice down here, this is the level that's not going to have any fog lights. Also, if you wanted to add LED fog lights, I believe that's not possible on the LE model, but you can switch out the traditional halogen bulbs on something like an XLE and above. You can switch those out for LEDs. So that's a little caution there. But this has a nice, sort of aggressive in your face, bold front grille. You know RAV4 is coming. It also has Toyota Safety Sense 2.0, so it's got some extra features on it as well, which will benefit you. I wanted to show off the other sides of the vehicle because this Ruby Flare Pearl, it pops, it shines, it shows itself off very nice. It glistens and sparkles in the sunshine. But on the other side of the sun, this is what it looks like here. So dimmer lighting, you'll still see the red, but it won't be as brilliant. Now this has the fuel tank on the driver's side. It's 14.5 gallons. It has front disc brakes and rear disc brakes along with 17-inch wheels. Now these ones right here, they're not the alloy wheels. They're gonna have the wheel coverings, but the nice thing about them is it's not like they're gonna fall off like an old 70s station wagon with the paneling where you see the big giant heavy hubcap go roo, 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 down the road. Did you like that? Roo, 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 roo. Roo, roo, roo. Anyway, the wheel coverings, it's not like they're gonna fall off or anything like that, and they do look good. I guess they could, from a far point away, look like they're alloy wheels, maybe. It's windy, so I'm stopping. LE model has a traditional key. It does not have smart key push button start. It also does not have the auto open feature when you walk up to it, beep beep, or you could lock it right here. So that's not in the LE. It also does not come with blind spot monitor or rear cross traffic alert. This is what our RAV friend looks like with the back hatch up. On the LE model, it's not a power back hatch, and you cannot get a power back hatch as well. So, but it's real easy to open. And also, there's a nice wide, deep, tall, very usable cargo area. We've got a storage pocket here, which is handy to put things in. There's a little light. Show me the light. It's also got some tie downs back here by the hatch. These are the tethers for child safety seats. You can also get a tonneau cover that hides your luggage. It goes in the little slots right there. Let's put the seats down. See that? Nice and flat. See that? I told you the earth was flat. I mean, the RAV4 storage space was flat. So now you can pile things up really tall. It's very versatile for moving things. There you go. And I think this goes down just a little bit more. Can you use this space, folks? Let's take a look inside from the passenger side. You'll see a smart storage shelf. Also, nice wide and deep storage platform here. It's got USB port, electronic parking brake, brake hold, and then three different driving modes for more more rapid acceleration for the sport mode. Normal is normal mode. Eco is better gas mileage. Eco is short for economy. It does not have any USB ports in here. That would be on the higher levels. It has a digital temperature control, just like that. And you can change where the air comes out by pushing this button. A lot of people don't realize this is the button to control the mode. Front defroster, rear defroster, and then that's for the coolest. Snack packs are the coolest. All right, we've got our audio. And then here's a benefit. Remember, this is the entry level. It's got Sirius XM. So that's a huge selling feature there, is that you get access to all those stations like Howard Stern and the Best of 80s and Pop Rocks and Hip Hop Nation and, well, frankly, everything. That's what the display looks like there. It does not come with a power driver's seat, just so you know. But it does have lighted mirrors, a sunglass holder, standard safety connect. Just like that. I'm trying to personally revolutionize car buying. So if you're in a different city or state than North Carolina in Raleigh, please contact me anyway. You can email me at toyotajeff1@gmail.com. Let me know what you're interested in. And if you're looking for a car, truck, or SUV, tell me the exact vehicle, the perfect vehicle you'd want. Chances are pretty good we either have it or we can get it from one of our trading partners. Then you get some choices. You can either fly in, I know it's kind of crazy times right now, but you could fly in and then drive your vehicle back home. You could also drive it down, maybe a trade-in, and then drive the new one back. Or we can deliver it to you. I have a transport company and we just pass along the charges for the delivery company. Either way, my goal is to make it as smooth, easy, fun, and safe as possible. Plus you get to work with me, who actually knows what they're talking about when facilitating a car deal. So thank you guys so much. Give me a try. So what do you think, gang? Are you buying what I'm selling? Are you picking up what I'm laying down? Write down in the comment sections what you think about RAV4 LE. Could it be for you? What color would you pick? One big improvement is there's now soundproofing material underneath all of the gasoline-only powered RAV4s. That was not on the 2019 model. You guys wrote in your comments and feedback. People like me passed it on to Toyota. They listened to you and they changed it. Now, what powers this thing? 203 horsepower, 184 foot-pounds of torque with a 2.5 liter four-cylinder engine that's matched up with a combo tag team. It's like Batman. Pow! Zap! Kaboom! With an 8-speed automatic transmission. And frankly, I think it's a very smooth gliding. You'll see that when you test drive it, whether you're on the highway or country roads or anywhere. So, it's got multi-link rear suspension, McPherson struts in the front, so it's smooth on the highways. It's tight going around turns. It's the best of everything. It's the best of both worlds. Best of both worlds. Thank you, Van Halen. Remember, there was no David Lee. There was no Sammy. There's Toyota Jeff. I want the best of both worlds. The RAV4 LE window sticker shows us that we're getting 35 mpg on the highway, 27 in the city. It combines for 30. That's a big bump up from the last generation. It's got good safety ratings. This one here is made in Canada. It could also be made in Japan, but see that Ruby Flare Pearl Macadamia 1-2 punch. On the left-hand side, you'll see standard features and options that will be from the factory. Love the technology upgrades. That's big. Has no options added at the factory, although it does have that Ruby Flare color. You'll also see that, like, you know, windchill pearl or a blizzard pearl color. You'll always see that extra charge.
It's a special paint mixing process. So we delivered it to the dealerships. It's got some extra options on it. This particular one, they don't all, but this one has a cargo mat, floor mats, paint protection, rear USB ports, cable charging package. And then this one will retail for $28,302.
Thanks so much for watching. Please follow my column on torquenews.com/Toyota for all about the world of Toyota. You'll like it, I think. And then also subscribe, follow me on Facebook and Instagram. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate you all. Please be safe out there. The world's a scary place these days, but not here. Woo! The only thing scary here is my singing and my dancing. Yeah, goodbye.